بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء، واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام، إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم، ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد، فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. Indeed, the praise is for Allah. We praise Him, we seek His help, and we seek His forgiveness. We seek refuge with Allah from the evils that are within ourselves and from our bad deeds. Whomsoever Allah guides, no one can lead this person astray. And whomsoever Allah leads astray, then there is no guide for him. I bear witness that none has the right to be worshipped except for Allah, who is alone with our partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the servant of Allah and his last messenger to all of mankind. O you who believe, fear Allah with the right that he should be feared with, and do not die unless you are Muslims. O mankind, fear your Lord who has created you from a single person, and from that person created his mate, and from them too scatter countless men and women throughout the earth. And fear Allah, from whom you demand your mutual rights, and do not cut off the relations with the wombs that have bore you. Indeed, Allah is a watcher over you. O you who believe, fear Allah and say that which is correct and upright, in order that Allah may rectify for you your deeds and forgive you of your sins. And whomsoever obeys Allah and His Messenger has achieved a tremendous achievement. As to what follows, certainly the most truthful speech is the Book of Allah, and the best guidance is the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the most evil of the affairs are the newly invented matters in the religion. And every newly invented matter in the religion is innovation, and every innovation is going astray, and every going astray is in the hellfire. Without a doubt, this has been a trying year for mankind, Muslims and non-Muslims alike. But the believers, we have guidance that guides us through the times of trials and tribulations, guidance that keeps us in tune in that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with, guidance that will protect us from going astray during the times of trials and tribulations. Allah Azza wa Jalla, He mentions in the Quran, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ وَمَن يُؤْمِن بِاللَّهِ يَهْدِ قَلْبَهُ. Allah, He mentions that there is no calamity that befalls mankind except by the permission of Allah. And whoever believes in Allah, Allah guides his heart. Alqama rahimahullah, he commented on the statement of Allah and he said, Huwa ar-rajul tusibuhu al-musiba فَيَعْلَمْ أَنَّهَا مِنْ عِنْدِ لَهُ فَيُسَلِّمْ وَيَرْضَى. It is the person who is afflicted with a calamity, a hardship, a difficulty, and he knows with surety that this is from Allah. So as a result of his knowledge that this matter is from Allah and outside of his control, he submits and he is pleased with that which Allah has decreed. This is the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala upon the one who believes that in the times of trials and tribulations, Allah, He guides the heart of the believer to submit to the decree of Allah and to be pleased and content with that which Allah has decreed, and to observe the patience upon the hardships and the difficulties, because we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tests the believers in this life. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he passed by a woman who lost her child. And she was crying at the grave. فَقَالَ لَهَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ اِتَّقِي لَا وَاسْبِرِي. So the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he advised her. He said, have fear of Allah and be patient. قَالَتْ إِلَيْكَ عَنِّي فَإِنَّكَ لَمْ تُصَبْ بِمُصِيبَتِي وَلَمْ تَعْرِفُهُ. So she said to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, get away from me, for you have not been afflicted with my calamity. But she did not know that that was the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. فَقَالَ النَّاسِ إِنَّهُ النَّبِيِّ. So the people said that was the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. فَذَهَبَتْ إِلَى بَيْتِهِ وَلَمْ تَجِدْ عِنْدَ بَابِهِ بَوَّابِينَ فَقَالَتْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ إِنِّي لَمْ أَعْرِفْكَ فَقَالَ لَهَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ إِنَّمَا الصَّبْرُ عِنْدَ الصَّدْمَةِ الْأُولَى. So she went to the home of the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And she said, oh Messenger of Allah, I did not know it was you. And then he responded to her, indeed, patience is at the first stroke of the calamity. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he advised his daughter when her son was dying, the grandson of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, inna lillahi ma akhadha وَمَا أَعْطَى وَكُلٌ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ بِأَجْلٍ مُسَمَّى فَتَصْبِرْ وَلَتَحْتَسِبْ. She called for the Messenger to come as her son was dying. And the Prophet Muhammad sent back the message, indeed, for Allah is that which He takes and that which He has given. And everyone has an appointed term with Allah. Therefore, be patient and seek His reward. And the Prophet Muhammad himself, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, When his son Ibrahim alayhi salam passed away, he observed patience upon this calamity. And he said, إِنَّ الْعَيْنِ تَطْمَعْ وَالْقَلْبْ يَحْزَنْ وَلَا نَقُولْ إِلَّا مَا يُرْضِي رَبَّنَا. Indeed, the eyes shed tears, and indeed the heart is saddened, but we do not say anything except that which pleases our Lord. This is the guidance of Islam when it comes to dealing with calamities, trials, and tribulations, especially the calamity of losing a loved one. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا أَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. أما بعد، قال الله عز وجل: إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. Indeed, those who are patient, they will be given a reward with no limit. وَقَالَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ. And indeed, Allah is with those who are patient. وَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ فَإِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ خَيْرٌ وَلَيْسَ ذَٰلِكَ لِأَحَدٍ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُ سَرَّاءُ شَكَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَإِذَا أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءُ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ أو كما قال صلى الله عليه وسلم. الله سبحانه وتعالى, He will give those who are patient a beautiful reward that has no limit. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with those who are patient. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned how amazing is the affair of those who are patient. For indeed, how amazing is the affair of the believer. For indeed, all of his affair is good. And that is for no one except for the believer. If a matter of good befalls the believer, he is grateful to Allah. He thanks Allah and this is good for him. And if a matter of difficulty or hardship befalls the believer, he is patient and that is good for him. And this is our life. We are between happy days and sad days. On the days when we experience happiness, we must be grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And on those days where we experience sadness and difficulty, we must be patient with the decree of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and both affairs are good for us, and both affairs are from the faith of the believer. I end with the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and a story connected to the statement. Allah, He mentions, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقَصٍ مِنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنْفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Allah, He mentions, we will surely test you. We will surely test you with something of fear and hunger and loss of wealth, in loss of life, in loss of produce, and give glad tidings to those who are patient. الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Those who, when a calamity happened to them, they say, indeed we are for Allah, and indeed to Allah we shall return. And any time we hear about the death of a loved one, the death of an imam, a Muslim, a believer, a friend, a colleague, when we hear about the death of our brothers and sisters, the first thing we say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. And this is the correct response, because losing a loved one is a calamity. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he mentioned, إِذَا أُصِيبَ أَحَدُكُمْ بِمُصِيبَةٍ فَلْيَذْكُرْ مُصِيبَتَهُ بِهِ فَإِنَّهَا أَعْظَمُ الْمُصَائِبِ. That when one of you is afflicted with a calamity, then let him remember his calamity that has taken place by way of my death. For indeed, my death is the greatest of the calamities. So losing the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that's the greatest calamity that has befallen the Muslim Ummah. Death is a calamity. So when we hear about the death, yes, the correct response is Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. Al-Fudail ibn Iyad rahimahullah, he said to a man, how old are you? The man said, I'm 60 years old. قال أنت منذ 60 سنة تسير إلى ربك وتوشك أن تبلغ. He said, since 60 years you have been traversing on the path towards your Lord, and you will soon reach it. So the man, when he heard this, he said, إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون. So when the man heard this statement, he said, indeed, we are for Allah, and indeed to Allah we shall return. Al-Fudail, he said, Ta'lam tafsira? Do you know the meaning of this statement? Faqala fassirhu lana ya Aba Ali. So the man said, well, explain it to us, O father of Ali. Qala rahimahullahu ta'ala, Qawluk inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. تقول أنا لله عبد. Your statement of إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون, you are saying, I am a slave or a servant of Allah. وأنا إلى الله راجع, and I am returning back to Allah. فمن علم أنه عبد الله, so whoever knows that he is a servant of Allah, وَأَنَّهُ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُ فَلْيَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّهُ مَوْقُوفٌ. So whoever knows that he is a servant of Allah and he has to return back to Allah, then let him know that one day he will stand in front of Allah. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَوْقُوفٌ فَلْيَعْلَمْ بِأَنَّهُ مَسْؤُولٌ. And whoever knows that he will stand in front of Allah, then let him know that he's going to be questioned by Allah. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَسْؤُولٌ فَلْيُعِدْ لِلسُّؤَالِ جَوَابًا. And whoever knows that he's going to be questioned by Allah, then let him prepare the answer. Let him prepare the answer. So the man, he said, فَمَا الْحِيلَ? What's the plan? How do we escape this? Al-Fudail, he said, يَسِيرًا. It is easy. He went on to say, تُحْسَن فِيمَا بَقِيَ يُكْفَرْ لَكَ مَا مَضَى وَمَا بَقِيَ. Do good with that which remains from your life, and you will be forgiven for that which has passed, and you will be forgiven for that which remains. فَإِنَّكَ إِنْ نَسَأْتَ فِي مَا بَقِيَ أُخِذْتَ لِمَا مَضَى وَمَا بَقِيَ. And if you do evil and that which remains from your life, then you will be taken to account for that which has passed and for that which remains. What's the point here? A lot of times, when we say Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un, this is just the response to the calamity. But we overlook the aspect of this statement that is referring to us. Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. We are servants of Allah. We will return to Allah. We must do good with that which remains of our life. Because we will stand in front of Allah and we will be questioned by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we must be prepared for this day. For those who have passed away, then they are going forward to that which they have sent forth. But those of us who are still alive, we have to do good with that which remains. And this is a point that we must keep in mind whenever we say, Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. For the life of this world is a test. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to be from those who pass the test. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from amongst those who die upon Islam and the Sunnah. As Al-Imam Ahmad, he used to make the dua, Allahumma amitna ala al-Islam wa sunnah. Allahumma amitna ala al-Islam wa sunnah. Allahumma amitna ala al-Islam wa sunnah. Oh Allah, cause us to die upon Islam. Cause us to die upon Islam and cause us to die upon the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Cause us to die upon Islam. Cause us to die upon the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Oh Allah, cause us to die upon Islam. Cause us to die upon the way of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لي ولكم وسبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. أقم الصلاة.